Well, hello, my friends. Welcome. So today we're going to be doing two little globe ornaments. And we're going to keep it simple for the month of November. We're going to do a lot of little fun tutorials that will hopefully be a bit easier. So to start off, I want you to grab anything circular in your house, whether it be a cup or a jar or anything, and trace yourself a circle. I did this design twice because I wasn't 100% happy with my first one, and I encourage you to do the same because you can explore different designs, different techniques, and just have fun and experiment with it. One, I did just the basic globe, and then I also added a string to the top and then some leaves and foliage, which you will see once I actually start painting them in. And I realized afterwards that you really couldn't see me drawing at this point. So and then we are going to actually use salt, just table salt, whatever salt you have on hand, to create some texture and some interest. So the one I have in this container is actually a mixture of kind of fine and coarse salt, but use whatever you have on hand. When it comes to salt, actually different coarseness and fineness of the salt itself will create different effects. So it's kind of cool to experiment with different kinds. And actually it will affect different pigments as well. So there's some of the glittery paints that I have actually don't give me the textured quality compared to regular pigments when I use the salt technique. So depending on what kind of paints you use, it might vary and be different. And I am a big fan of turquoise. It's probably my favorite color. So I'm going to do turquoise for actually both ornaments that I do. But feel free in this tutorial, use whatever colors you want. Mix colors, use them straight from the palette box. I don't care. Just be creative. Do what colors make you feel happy. So once you've got your color prepped and mixed, we want to wet the entire globe with some water. I left a few little white patches just for some variation and contrast. Get the whole thing wet. Don't have it sopping wet. Once you've got it sufficiently wet, then you're going to take your prep pigment and you're just going to start placing it down on the paper. And you can see I don't go and do just a complete wash. I'm just kind of lightly dabbing in the color. Just gonna speed this up so it doesn't take so long. So once you get the first layer of color, I actually went in a second time while the paper was still wet, and I'd put in some darker pigment on the left hand side to kind of create an illusion of a shadow almost. Once you're done and you're satisfied, you just take your salt and then you're just gonna sprinkle it on the entire wet portion of the painting. Over time, I've kind of experimented with putting more or less salt on it, and it creates different effects. So just go with what your gut says and you'll see the results. Next, I actually went in with a clean brush with a little bit of water on it, and I put some of that water onto the painting, just in little dots around the ornament. And what that's going to do is it's actually the water is going to push the pigment out and create just a little bit more texture. It's actually called blooming, and a lot of beginners actually make this mistake and have too much water on their brush and they go over the pigment and create these blooms. But you can do it intentionally as well, and it creates a cool texture. Now, to make this most effective, this technique, you actually need to let it dry naturally. So I let it sit for about 10 to 15 minutes. Go grab yourself a snack, a coffee, come back. And then once it had sufficiently worked its magic, I actually finished off the drying process with a hairdryer. And you want it to get it to like bone dry. You don't want any part wet. Once it's completely dry, you can actually just rub the salt off in kind of a circular motion. I find works really well, and then just dispose of it
however you like.
Next, I'm working on the foliage, which you couldn't see because my pencil drawing was too light. So I just took a couple different kinds of greens. This leaf I did quite light, and then the next one I did kind of like a darker green. You choose whatever color makes you happy. And you can see in this video, once the globe has dried, it had such a cool texture. I actually, between the two ornaments that I did, I really, really like the texture of this one the best. It was so pretty. Next, I'm just finishing some of the last details on this Christmas foliage. And I'm doing all of this work on dry paper. So I'm not pre-wetting it. It's just going pigment onto paper, and which makes it pretty easy. And it went pretty quick. And like I said before, I'll scavenge the internet for some inspiration photos for you guys to work from, just different ideas. You really make it your own, get creative, and try a few different variations. That sometimes we do it the first time and maybe we learn what we like and we don't like about the piece, and then we can do it again and kind of refine it and perfect it. And there's no shame in that. As you can see, like, I did two ornaments, and I actually really preferred the second one that I did because I kind of took the things that I didn't like about this one and just made it better in the second version. Next, I'm going in with this gold pigment. I've got these metallic Viviva watercolors that I've been kind of experimenting with. I don't use them very often, but I thought I would try the gold color out on this ornament. And so I just go over some of the areas. I do the string gold, and then I go in on the ornament itself and create some little dot details and some stars around the globe. And I want you to get as complicated or simple. Use that creativity and just make it your own. I'd love to see what you guys come up with. And so up next, I'm going to start on the second ornament. And I'm going to go through this a little bit faster just because we've kind of done it already. So the second rendition, I really simplified it and made it a little more elegant, less cluttered. I started out with the ornament part a little more centered, lower in the page. The first time I did it, it was like way too high. And I actually go and sketch in these little leaf details all over the globe. And I go in with a similar shade of turquoise as I did the first time, but I actually watered it down quite a bit and I went lighter this time. And you can see there I'm putting in the salt, and I actually go back and darken it up a little bit. So I take a bit of darker pigment and just plop that in on the left-hand side again, just to kind of darken that area up because I wasn't quite happy with just how light it was. But I also wanted to keep it light enough that I could see the pencil sketch underneath. And once I finished darkening up to my desired contrast, I actually went over it again with a little bit more salt just to help texturize that pigment that I had just put down. And yet again, wait for it to dry and then take off the salt. And on to the next part. So I did this in two stages, actually. I put down that gold pigment that I used on the previous painting, and I wasn't quite happy with the look of that. So I actually went back over it with a shimmery green color, and the two kind of mixed, and I was pretty happy with that. And then I took my white gouache and I actually outlined all of the leaves, and I was really happy with this look. It just made the foliage really pop. I was kind of contemplating using a waterproof pen and going and outlining that way, but I decided on the gouache and I was pretty happy with that. Then once I finished the outlining, I went in with the gold and the white gouache, and I just made dots all around the globe. And if you like that look, actually do it in small dots and large dots. So we'll keep some variation in between them. And see here, I'm showing off kind of like the two versions. Like I said, I really liked the second version. It just seemed simpler and more elegant. And at this time, my little 2-year-old was joining me in the painting process. So here she is, making quite the mess, but enjoying herself nonetheless. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video.